Big Joe! Cheap travels. Travel on a budget. So, walking to the old town of Dubrovnik. Here's like a graveyard with a nice stone church on top and some wall. So we left our car somewhere down there, and so this is the way to the old city center. You just follow the tourists, it's easy to find. And in case you need a rest, there's like a small park there. So, some villas. And yeah. It's so warm and hot. So, a few more kilometers of this heat. So to get to the old city center, we'll have to continue down this way. Just wanted to show the house there, the stone house, but yeah, I'm just relaxing now in the shade, and then we'll continue down to the old town. So, time to go on. And to see the views. Just around the corner, I think we should be able to see the view of the old town of the Dubrovnik. Fly attacking me. But here they put locks on the fence, like to. Like a sign of internal love and good luck, you know. And yeah, the view of the coast, but still not of the old city. We have to walk a little bit further just after that hill there. But yeah, there's a nice view of the hotel. And for those who are tired and want to enjoy the views, there are some benches here. And a nice view down over the coastal line. There's like an old gate there that leads to the cemetery that we just walk around. So if you want, you can also take the cemetery and you get down here and see the cemetery. It has a nice church there and maybe some monuments there, you know. just here on the left side, we have Kino, Kavana, Slavia, which is now Bar Frateos. And up ahead we have Mirador, the viewing point. And yeah, let's see what we can see from there. There are some benches which are calling my name. That's still the coastline. The view. And let's take that bench there. Coastline and the way to the old town. But now it's time for me to rest a little bit, and yeah, see you in a bit, guys. So, I'm in Dubrovnik, and we will be trying today a new beer called Pan, which is about 5% alcohol, and it's made in Serbia, by Carlsberg, Serbia, so let's give it a try. This one is a little bit more bitter, quite a bit more bitter than beer. I don't like so much bitter beer, so 2.5 out of 5, maybe. Okay, it's the only one I get, so. And we're off from this viewing point. Let's go to the old city now. There's a big cliff down there. Very nice house. So here the descent starts down to the old town of Dubrovnik. They're renovating. Oh, a church here. Catholic one. This will be a nice climb back up when we go back to the car. this building here is? I don't know. Wait. So it's like a university of the Dubrovnik. There you go. The university building. Small house just next to university. I think it's gardens actually after behind it. University building. If you want to sit in the shade, this is a nice resting place, and of course, you know me. Oh. 5 minute break just to rest a bit, and we continue down to the old city. So, see you then. So the nice view from my bench here, it's actually a bus stop, but yeah, nice shade, so it's good to cool down. And now it's time to go back on our merry way to the old town of Trebinje. More nice houses next to the road. If you're adventurous, you can take this stair, so. You gotta be careful not to trip, because they're like hidden steps. Yeah. Yeah, a nice abandoned house. Just up there. Here we have like a chapel thingy. And a very nice garden just next to it. Yeah, it's like a park. With some old tree in the middle, which I think is dead already, but yeah. Nice. pillars from Venice Republic, I think. And then yeah, this old tree, which is dead. And there's some house there. Hope it's not a private property. Then we are trespassing. Better get out. There's a nice garden. Oh, there's even some emblem there. So, I think that's an emblem of the Dubrovnik or Venetian Republic, something like that. And more pillars on each side. So, when we come out of this, there's this small church on the other. On the other side. But yeah, let's go to the old town. Still have some way to walk, maybe 500 meters or so, until we reach the old town. Another nice building, small garden in front. This is students' home here. Just above Dubrovnik, you have this lift that goes up, and it goes up here, and you can take it from the center of the town, and from there you have a beautiful view of all Dubrovnik. Otherwise there also goes a road that goes around there, so you can also reach it by car, if you have a car. And from there, it's the most beautiful view of Dubrovnik. We are getting closer to the entrance to the old town. Look, two nice doggy statues there. Restaurant here. Sesame restaurant. Another abandoned villa. Dubravka, built in 1902. A And there we have Grand Hotel Imperial. Not this one, but the next one. It feels like a church. Let's check it out. Quite empty church, so not so interesting. So we came from that side and we go to the right to the city center. Old city center. At least there is shade here, so it's more bearable to walk. Oh, this is the Imperial, Grand Imperial Hotel. What? We're more interested in the old buildings just across it. Like, as you can see, the tourists are already cramping up the streets of Dubrovnik. Okay, let's see. Sandwiches, pizzas. If you watch my previous video, you will see that in Bosnia I had a much better food for much less money. So that's why, if plans to plan ahead, it's good to plan ahead. People also have pizza and burek here, so a little pizza is like 2 or 3 euros, the same as I paid for the big pleskavica in Bosnia. Yeah, I guess this is the last bus station that the buses drive actually to. So here you can buy a ticket for the bus, and it costs, let me see, it doesn't say the price, so who knows. I feel like I'm in the middle of an ant house. So many people. There's a well with the water. I still have my water, so I think I'll sit down there a bit. And there, we'll go there to see the view of the fortress. But I need a 5-minute break. Thank you. So a lot of people still coming to the city. It will be crowded, I tell you. There's actually a tourist information center there. That's the building over there. So maybe we should get a free map or something. That would be smart thing to do. That's the place where we can get a free map of the Dubrovnik. So let's just go and get our map.
Excuse me.
Is it here? Let me go get the map. Project mini guide. So we got our map. And now let's go see the city. First see the well with the water. Just to freshen up. Statue. And the view of the castle. Over the chest. This is the pipe. From 1900s. But let us go there for some views of the fortress surrounding the city. There you go, another fortress. And I guess this is kind of a romantic spot. So if you watched that series Game of Thrones, it was filmed here in Dubrovnik. Last view of the fortress and the entrance to the old port of Dubrovnik. And overpriced restaurants. A nice view of the castle. Some ice here. And the entrance to the old town. Where we will go now. Just here through the park you can go to rent your kayak there if you like to do that. Otherwise we go inside now. It's a nice pick. Yeah, this was the bridge when they could pull it out if the enemies came. Some souvenirs and traditional and the walls are quite extensive. So should we go here? Should we go there? Let's see. Let's go around to see what's there. And these are the gates where you enter. And there we go. Saint somebody. And this is the entrance to the old town. So some stone cannonballs. And what's down here? Let's check it out. Park Pile. Let's wait for the people. In we go. Ah, it's a small park. So you want to relax after the visiting of the whole town, you can come here and relax. some kind of gallery. But yeah, let's go inside. So we're in Dubrovnik. If you want to enter the city walls all the way up there, it costs 250 kunas. 1 euro is about 7 kunas, so you can calculate it. And there's another tourist center. And here is the river of tourists. There's a museum inside there. I don't know if you can see it. And the big fountain. Sorry. So yeah, let's start with the main street. Although we could also go there. Try that. Some restaurants. And the church, which is closed. I'd better go into shade, because the sun is quite warm. Or there's the city walls up there, which you can go around the city for 250 kunas. But as you know, I'm not a friend of heights, so we will not be doing that. If you need a shave, you can get a haircut like this. It's called a monk haircut. Fast food joints. And this is like a bakery. So that's probably our best option if you want to eat here. Not to overspend. And there are nice restaurants all the way in small alleys like this. Just to show you. That's how it looks like. And if you want to know the prices, there you go. About 30 to 40 euros. A salad for 15 euros. Risotto for 20 euros. So those are the prices in Dubrovnik if you want to go out in small restaurants. Have even wine shops. Yeah. It's a nice place to get lost. A nice alley. Just go into the shade so you'll see it better. Okay. Thank you. the entrance. But let us head further inside the city. This is nice city street. Another nice street with another restaurant. So it's like fast food restaurant. For about 10 euros you can get a kebab, so I would say overpriced. And there's another nice street just across it. Yes. You want to taste olive oils. Another small street. Okay, let's go to the other side. Because it's a bit more shady. I mean, it's in the shade, it's not shady. But yeah, lots of souvenir shops with hats, jewelry. Candy, Captain Candy. That's nice. Let's check it out. Oh, they have lots of candies here. And it also smells nice, very sweet. Another small street to get lost in. And on the other side as well. This is quite normal prices. You can get a burger for 13 euros. Which is still five times more than you can get it in Bosnia. There we go. the church. It's against the sun, so. Okay, let's check it out and see if it's for free. Then we go inside. Actually, it's quite warm in the church, so we'll go out because it's cooler. And sit on these steps, I guess, for 5 minutes and then continue to the old town exploration. So guys, 5 minutes rest, then we continue. See you in a bit. So, it's time to continue. Pope John II bless this city. So here it says Dugana, which means border in French, I think. Nice review of the church and of the old town. So this is the street of Saint Dominic. Here we've got the seaside. With ice cream. Live music and boat tours. Well, the closest island is this one, Lokrum. I guess it costs about 20 euros to go there and back. 50 minutes costs 110 kunas. Well, that's 15 euro if you want to just circle the island. Restaurant is about 20 to 25, 30 euros for a meal. And you can get Mediterranean cuisine, which is basically fish or pasta, stuff like that. Risotto. I guess there are the toilets. So up there you have the Dominican Monastery Museum. Some souvenirs.
And those steps.
House. Ah, yes. This is the Dominican Monastery.
I dodge.
So I guess it's closed for renovations. Souvenir shop with paintings, some wines. And there's one more small church in the end. And if you take the tour around city walls, you'll be up there, walking, climbing.
Thank you.
Oh, here we have some old tombstones. I like cannonballs. Let's see. Oh, I think that's the best. There you go. And there, the people on top of the fortress. And if you like art, there's a lot of selects of paintings.
By the painting, the bulletin.
There is the fucking scammer there.
Why would you want?
Oh, summer's quite nice. Well, there's the maps of the city, and there's a bench for me to sit. If there's no bird shits, no. Let's get it. So, the free gates and the church. And time for Big Jack to take 5 minutes off because I'm sweating. See you in a bit, guys. So I had my rest. It's time to continue exploring the city of Dubrovnik. Yeah. So let's see what's behind this gate. Another gate, and then another gate. Yeah. Like, here we go for the view.
Yes, it is.
It's getting a little more open.
Yeah, for 450, 400, and then for 20 back. Like, yes. Okay, thank you.
He knows that too.
The restaurant, I like a small park here. Let's go to see the cannon. So I guess they're folk dancing here. Folk dance Lindo, Dubrovnik, Croatia. And there's the alley of locker room, I think it is. Another view from here, different angle. A small beach. And there the city ends and a new city begins. So we'll go back to see another part of the city that we haven't been yet, which is there on the other side. There are a few more churches there, so let's go see that. A nice view of the bell tower from here. The monastery and the church. And here the three figures of some holy man. We can enter the city walls. Non,
this is 360.
Ready?
And Dalmatian dogs in Dalmatia. So if you want ice cream, here you have pepinos gelato. Souvenirs, cloths. This is Marin Držić. Mayor of Dubrovnik from 15 something. But I see a bench, so 5 minute rest. Thank you. So it's time to continue the last part of the Dubrovnik. Oh, this is Knežev Dvor. I don't know if street enter.
Okay, you can concentrate here on the subway.
I'll just see. So that was the exit actually. This is the entrance where you must buy the tickets. Well, you've seen it for free. We'll head there after we have seen all from the left side or the right side. So there you have Game of Thrones exchange. Well, let's see if we can get into the church. The pipes. So that's the church we were just in. Now, let's see the seaside again. Let's walk around the fortress walls. Just next to the sea.
Markane.
To si umieš.
This is the aquarium.
Thank you.
video can only go back.
That's a great idea.
Ma pacianički, naravno čujem ja Anto moga dobro.
Boat bar. Small beach if you wanted to swim here, and there's the island of Lokrum.
Thank you.
we'll go back, and then when we're inside the city walls, I'll continue recording. Oh, we're going back to the old city of Dubrovnik. This is where we came from, and just behind there you have a small beach where you can take a swim if you have your swimming suits on. There's a nice emblem there. Okay, let's go see. Let's check the pizza price. Oh, about 15 euros for pizza.
City walls
right? Okay, so that's the way to the aquarium as well. I've been there before. Thank you. So now we're entering the hidden streets of Dubrovnik. As you can see, no tourists here. That's why they're here. I made it to the top of the stairs.
Turn your
back.
crowded church. I'll sit here for a while and then we continue down there.
Same scene, just the camera was on the top,
so I made it down the stairs. Now let's go here.
If he decides to come back to King's Landing, they might come back over here or House of the Dragon.
I'm not going up the stairs again. Sorry, guys. So I got tonight at church. Let's see. Umjetnička škola. Art school, Dubrovnik. Okay, let's not invade people's houses. So, if you want to escape the tourists, you just climb up to this street. And it's still going up. Who knows where? it's not much further. And then it goes up again. My God. I'm beat. Small garden. Right there. I hope it goes down as well. Not just up. Otherwise we'll go down here because this one actually, let's see what's the kind of corner. It's not that bad. Okay, and here it goes up as well. Quite tiring to climb up here. That's why almost no tourists here. Oh, look. But I'm not going up there. This one goes up again. Oh my God. I think I'll go down there. Just look if you want to go up. There's a long way.
Ne, znaš šta ćemo stari, ne, ja ću, ti plati pizzu, ja ću taksi, pa ćete mi dao što se tako.
We are going down. Okay, people are coming from this street, let's check it out. Small hidden street. So far so good. So far so good. I just hope it's not a street that ends there. It could be. It could be. Dead street. Dead end street. Don't tell me it's a dead end street. My God. Of course. What else? I'm so tired. And then we come to this street. We go down here to another dead end street. Can I sit here just for a while? Ugh, like a bum. I'm absolutely beat, guys. Look, sweating like There's no more sweat in me. Five minutes break, then we continue. So we're getting out of the street. And going downstairs to the main street where the entrance to the city is. So down there. Hope I don't fall on these steps. Oh, that's the way we came. Still a long way down. Restaurant. Another little church here. Art gallery. And more restaurants. Like a churchyard gallery, let's see. Okay, so it's like an exhibition of paintings. Ooh, a big restaurant here.
Okay, you go first. Go first. He's going first and then I'm going first.
There's another candy shop there. I guess we go left. Captain Candy. Candy shop. Jewelry fingers. I nicely to left. There's the bell shot. Bell dollar. Holy Burak. I don't know, hard to think. Yeah, we are at the exit. So, we made it out of Dubrovnik, almost. Out of the old city. So I guess we will refill our water here, because I already have tea here. I'll need both hands for this, so see you after I refill. From this guy, drinking water. And here's the entrance to the city center. And at this well, you can refill your water for free before you head out to the old town.
Wiedzieć obok siebie w innym miejscu, a reszta jest sama.
nas.
So we say bye bye to the fountain and to the Dubrovnik old town and continue back to the new town.
Yo. dacă vrei să vezi un zid de sus pe acolo, știi, plătești, trei persoane în hotel.
So as you have seen, Dubrovnik is quite popular tourist destination with lots of people, and I hope you liked it, because we'll finish our video here. If you liked it, press that like button, comment and subscribe. I'll try to find a place to sit, but as you can see, that's mission impossible. Unless I take this corner here, which I will do. So I'll keep rolling for a few more minutes, but this is the end of the video, so take care, guys.
Yeah, sure, I'll go to the hotel.
So thank you guys for watching. I hope you subscribe to my channel, put a like there, and see you next time.